Okay, so the important role played by the Arabs in architecture. Actually, they had given two important features or two important style in the building, that is called dome and minaret. Dome means semicircular shape. As you can see, boys, students, that if you see any mosque, you will see at the top of the mosque semicircular construction, that is called dome. And besides that, you will see long towers, that is called minarets. Actually, the role of minarets was to invite Muslims for the prayers. And now these are a part of architecture, Islamic architecture. So I can say that Arab civilization was a developed civilization, as well as it was a very big and powerful civilization. But it was not easy, because the Arabians were divided before arrival of Islam. You can say that, or I can say that, it was the Muhammad who played very important role to unite the Arabians. The religion which he established, that religion united the people of Arab. The different tribes who were always engaged in war, they gave up war and they became ready to work together. And because of their togetherness, the Arab become a powerful nation. Now, I have explained you the five pillars of Islam. Now, I will explain the five principles. Okay? Islam asks his followers to do. And they are, a Muslim should not worship an idol. Idol means Muslims will not worship any images. Next, he must not lend money on interest. Muslims cannot lend money on interest, or they cannot take interest from anyone. He should lead a life of virtue and benevolence. Means they must have a pure and peaceful life. They should not be involved in any wrong things or activities. All Muslims must regard themselves as brothers and equals. Why? Because Prophet Muhammad wanted to unite the people of Arab, unite the different tribes of Arab. That is why he focused too much on this particular thing, that the Muslims always treat each other brotherly and equals. Now, students, we will discuss about the questions. Okay, the questions are not very tough. So far, as you can see, there are some tick the correct answers. As you can see, which among the following places Muhammad was forced to live? Medina, Damascus, Mecca, and Baghdad. So actually, Muhammad was in Mecca, but he was forced to leave to Medina. So correct answer will be Medina. Next, who adopted the Arab as the language of administration? Actually, this will be Abu Bakr. Which of the following is not included in the five pillars of Islam? Salat, Hajj, Hijarat, okay, and Sahada. Actually, Hijarat is not included. Next, the Abbasids established their capital at. As you can see, the Abbasids established their capital in Baghdad. So Baghdad will be the correct answer. When did the rule of Ottoman Khalifa end? Actually, Ottoman Khalifa's rule ended in 1453. Then after, the Turks started to rule. Okay, fill in the blanks and others you can do by yourself. Now state whether the following statements are true or false. Muhammad was born at Medina. It is false. Muhammad born in Mecca. The Abbasid ruled for 500 years. Actually, Abbasids had ruled, 500 years. True. All Muslims should not worship an idol. True. Because it is again, Islam is against of image worship. Next is, Abu Bakr was the last Khalifa. Abu Bakr was not the last Khalifa, he was the first Khalifa. So it is false. Next is, the Ottoman Turks captured Constantinople in century 1480. No, The Ottoman Turks captured Constantinople in 1453 AD. So it is false. Rest, discuss the early life of Prophet Muhammad. In this particular question, you have to mention that about his birth period. You have to write about how he brought up by his uncle and when did he get spiritual experience. Describe the teachings of Muhammad. So the teachings of Muhammad are in, that is the five obligations which is necessary for all the Muslims to follow. What are the five main religious obligations? Already discuss the spread of Islam, mixed civilization after the passing away of Prophet Muhammad. So here you have to write about the role of these four khalifas, means which places they had captured. Then after you will write about the Umayyad dynasty and you will mention about the capital which was of the Umayyad dynasty. Then after you have to write about the which dynasty annexed the power of Khalifa Abbasids and what was the capital. Then after you have to mention about the Ottoman Turks, okay, who had annexed Constantinople. So Umayyads, main contribution of Umayyads and Abbasids, means you have to write the places which annexed by the Umayyads and Abbasids, as well as who were the great scientists, and you have to write about Umar Khayyam and his book. So we have discussed everything about the rise and spread of Islam. We have discussed. So I think that students, you will not have any doubt in this chapter. Again, we will next day we will meet with the new chapter, and I wish you to stay safe and do not go out and focus on your studies. Thank you. Good.